I kind of think of it like stretch marks, but in the retina. But whereas stretch marks are no big deal, when they're in the retina, they can cause big problems. Hello and welcome or welcome back. I'm Dr. Elisabeth, board certified optometrist, and today we're going to be talking about the dangers of myopia that your doctor probably hasn't told you. And the reason they probably haven't told you is that doctors have very limited time and there's so much to cover in an exam already. And a lot of these issues are just possibilities, but I think that preventative medicine is the best medicine. So if you have myopia, you may be at risk for these things, especially if you have a high prescription of myopia. So it's better to be in the know and to know what symptoms to look out for so that when something happens, you can call your doctor right away and you know what to do. Because a lot of these issues can lead to severe complications that can be avoided simply if you just react quickly. So let's get into it. Myopia, or nearsightedness, means that somebody has blurry vision at distance and clearer vision at near without any vision correction. In most cases, this is simple enough to correct with glasses, contacts, or sometimes surgical procedures like LASIK. What is it about myopia that makes it so dangerous? Well, there are two main causes of myopia, and they are one, having a thicker cornea, which is this front clear part of the eye. If the cornea is thick, it bends the light so that it reaches a focal point before it reaches the back of the eye, which would be the retina. So in myopia, this cornea, the front part of the eye, is simply too thick and too strong. One of the other causes of myopia would be that the axial length, which is the distance from the front of the eye to the back of the eye, is too long. This would mean that if all else is the same as a normal eye, like the cornea, let's say, is a normal thickness, that the light would, again, land before the retina because the eye is too long. So it's this long axial length in myopia that tends to be the issue here when we talk about myopia dangers. And that's what we're going to get into a little further in just a second. The first danger of myopia we're going to talk about today is retinal holes, tears, and detachments. I'm going to kind of group all of these together because they have similar symptoms to look out for. It is possible to have these conditions even if you don't have myopia, but if you have myopia, they are more likely, especially if you have high myopia, like above a -5. But the higher the prescription, the more likely a retinal hole, tear, or detachment is for you. And that's because the axial length of the eye that we talked about earlier. So in high myopia, this length gets longer and longer and longer, and that causes the retina to become stretched. The retina that lines the back of the eye is the neural tissue that allows you to see. It's like the film of the camera. And as this length increases, the retina becomes stretched. And the edge of the retina, which is along the back of the iris here, is the area that tends to develop holes and tears. Now, if you have a hole or a tear in the retina, the fluid that fills this part of the eye can get behind it and cause the retina to detach and fall forward. And this affects your vision, especially the peripheral vision at first, but if it detaches from the macula here, which is responsible for the very center of your vision, that can cause even worse issues, including blindness, and even after treatment, there can still be some visual distortion. So it's really important to know what to look out for. So symptoms of a retinal hole, tear, or detachment tend to be flashing lights in the peripheral vision, floaters, especially brand new ones, and a lot of them suddenly. A lot of people will describe a curtain closing over their vision, or like water filling up their vision. Any sudden changes like that should be a red flag for you. You might think that something with a word like hole or tear would be painful, but actually retinal holes and tears and detachments are not painful at all. And part of me kind of wishes that they were, only because I think that would prompt people to go to the doctor sooner, and it's always better to get treatment for these things sooner rather than later. Some people might not even have symptoms. For a retinal detachment, that would be pretty rare, but for a hole, that's definitely a possibility, and a retinal hole could lead to a detachment later. That's why doctors are always recommending annual dilated eye exam. So we can open up the pupil, look into the back of the eye with the lenses, and look to see if there are any holes or tears developing to catch things sooner. The long-term complications of a retinal hole tear or detachment could be loss of peripheral vision, and in severe cases, it could lead to severe loss of central vision, blindness, and distortion, even after treatment. So if you have any of those symptoms going on, it's always just better to call your doctor right away, see what they recommend, get checked out, and get any treatment as promptly as you can. The second danger of myopia to look out for is myopic degeneration, which could include staphyloma, angioid streaks, or lacquer cracks. Now, these are all much more common in people with high levels of myopia, like a -6 or greater. And that's again because of this increased axial length that causes stretching of the retina. A staphyloma is like an outpouching of the back of the eye that leads to atrophy of the tissue and decreased vision. And in severe cases, it can cause legal blindness. Lacquer cracks or angioid streaks are breaks in what's called the Bruch's membrane, which is between the retina and the blood supply. I kind of think of it like stretch marks, but in the retina. But whereas stretch marks are no big deal, when they're in the retina, they can cause big problems. Some people might not notice them. It all depends on their location. But if they cross directly over the macula, which is responsible for that very center of your vision, that can cause blurry vision or distortion that is not necessarily treatable. Now, you might think, okay, well, if I have these things, then they're not treatable. There's nothing really to be done. But actually, it's really important to monitor these regularly. Because of this change in the structure of the tissue, it is more likely to have new blood vessel growth or bleeding in those areas, which would require prompt treatment. So this is another example of why it's important to have regular dilated eye exams. Also, between appointments, people can monitor their vision at home with an Amsler grid. This is a grid that you look at every day, and if the lines start to become wavy instead of straight, or if things start to look blurry, it's a heads up that you should call your doctor. The third danger of myopia is glaucoma. Now, a lot of people, when they hear glaucoma, they just think that means high eye pressure, but that's not necessarily the case. The hallmark of glaucoma is optic nerve damage that leads to peripheral vision loss. There are a lot of different types of glaucoma, and the one that's the most common in people with high myopia is called open angle glaucoma. What we think is going on here is that this increased axial length of the eye causes this optic nerve to become tilted, which damages the axons of the nerve cells that go from the eye to the brain. And that causes first loss of the peripheral vision, but glaucoma is actually a slow progressing and insidious disease because it slowly causes reduction in your peripheral vision until it reaches tunnel vision, and then it can even snuff out the central vision as well. And it's kind of tough because people don't always notice that they're losing their peripheral vision because it happens so slowly. It's like watching your kid grow up day after day after day, and yeah, they look the same as they did yesterday, but the auntie who hasn't seen the kid in 5 years is like, oh my gosh, you look so different. Well, think of your doctor as your auntie. They're going to be checking you out, doing tests, and seeing these snapshots from this time to this time, and they'll be able to notice if there are changes going on. Whereas you, from day to day, you're not going to notice anything until it's possibly too late. Glaucoma is dangerous because this vision loss is irreversible. But the good thing is there are treatments, usually just with eye drops, and this can help to save your vision in the long run. So in glaucoma, there might not be as obvious of symptoms to give you a heads up to go to your doctor. Those regular dilated eye exams that they recommend should be sufficient in order to prevent these complications. The fourth possible danger of myopia is early cataract development. Now, everybody will get cataracts if they live long enough, but it's thought that people with myopia get cataracts at a younger age because of this increased axial length, making it more difficult for nutrients to get from the front of the eye to the back of the lens, which is located right here. And the lens is the part of the eye that becomes cloudy and develops a cataract. Now, I don't see this as such a problem because cataract surgery is so common nowadays that it's one of the surgeries that has the least likely complications, but it still is an invasive procedure and a surgery, and it shouldn't be taken lightly. But the good thing is cataract surgery is available to correct vision. And actually, it might help people that have high myopia because when you get this lens taken out, it's replaced with a lens implant, and this implant can correct your vision, making people less dependent or sometimes totally independent of vision correction. Some people that have high myopia actually elect to have their lens removed before it even develops a cataract. This is called clear lens extraction and can be actually quite beneficial. Of course, there are always possible complications and risks, so this is an important conversation to have with your doctor. So if you have myopia, remember these things, go to your annual eye exams, and don't hesitate to call your doctor if you feel like something's off. And be sure to share this video with a friend who has myopia. Survey says that 42% of Americans have myopia, so you could really help somebody out. Remember, I made this not to freak anybody out, but just to give awareness so people can take control of their own health. It's always good to know what to look out for, and preventative medicine is the best medicine. So thank you for watching, and I'd love to see you next time.